This is how Nicholas Kristol gained 100,000 subscribers in 1 month. And it's only a matter of time before he blows up your feed because he's already blown up everyone's feed. Just a year and a half ago, this kid was a no-name vlogger running through Italy before he got shut down by COVID. Now he's amassing over 100,000 new subscribers a month with no sign of slowing down. So how is he doing it? What is Nicholas Kristol doing that the rest of us aren't? What did he figure out that we haven't? After all, something must have changed for Nicholas to go from no-name kid with a DSLR to pretty much the next Matt D'Avella. Except he's even better. It's pretty genius what he's doing, and I think he may be a YouTube prodigy. This will only take a few minutes to explain the genius behind this guy's plan and how we can all learn and apply the same strategies. If you're new to the channel, welcome, because you are home, and to be honest, we need you. Subscribers to this channel are YouTube creators inspired to create and make the world a better place with their videos, and we need you as a creator. Nicholas makes really good videos, but no one would know if they didn't click on it in the first place. So how does Nicholas do such a good job of getting people to click on his videos? Well, after dozens of hours analyzing every single one of Nicholas's videos, I noticed something interesting. Nicholas struggled to get clicks in the beginning. It wasn't pretty. His first real video for YouTube was a vlog from Italy. Now, it's actually a good vlog that's fairly interesting. But back then, he had zero following and no one knew anything about him. So why would anyone want to watch a video about a no-name vlogger? Who's going to click on that? As harsh as this sounds, we don't care about a no-name vlogger. We don't care about a 100 sub gaming channel. That person or channel hasn't provided any value to us or solved any of our problems, so why do we want to know their life update? Good thing Nicholas is a smart guy because he immediately shifted his strategy after that first video. He began creating videos about what people did care about. Here's how he laid it out. First, he picked his pillar topics for his channel. Many tools can help do this, but PlannerVid is my personal favorite, link below in the description. Pillar topics are simply what is your channel about. Nicholas chose filmmaking, travel, and self-development. These are good choices because travel filmmaking is fairly niche for a specific audience, but self-development has the viral potential to reach a much larger audience. Now, for each of those pillars, Nicholas needs to know what are people actually searching for regarding these topics. This will give him a much higher chance of being discovered. Again, using a tool like PlannerVid, you can dig beneath the surface of YouTube to discover what people want to watch regarding your topic. Sure enough, Nicholas did figure out what people wanted to watch. For each keyword, he made several videos about that keyword. Now armed with his channel game plan, it was only a matter of time before his channel took off. But his game plan was so good, it didn't take much time. 4 videos later, Nicholas hit jackpot. From his research, turns out people really wanted to see cinematic footage of a new drone, and this video blew up. That's the power of knowing what people want to watch instead of just guessing. Smash that like if you have also made the mistake of making videos people just don't care about. Unfortunately, you're not alone. Well, the months went on and Nicholas stuck to that strategy. Pillars, keywords, videos. Each of his videos was focused on what people wanted to watch, so people clicked. He gave the YouTube algorithm a little more time to figure out his ideal viewer. And then it happened. Under his self-development pillar, one of his keywords was detox, and he made this video. 4.5 million views, 100,000 new subs in 1 month. That's the power of knowing what people want to watch. Some people call this trend jacking, and it is 100% essential for all new YouTube channels. Stop making life update vlogs when no one cares about you in the first place. Don't drone on about your Let's Play gaming videos and how they aren't getting views. Unfortunately, you have to build that rapport with people and give them value before they start wanting to know your life updates. Instead, do your research, map out your pillars and keywords, and start delivering value to viewers by making videos about what they want to watch. Stick to the plan, give people what they're searching for, and give it some time. Nicholas is a master at this, but getting people to click is only half the battle. Because if people click on your video, watch for 5 seconds, realize the video is not what they want, then bounce, then YouTube realizes, oh, this is a bad video, let's not show it to anyone. Aside from click-through rate, you need retention. Watch this intro from Nicholas's video and tell everyone in the comments, what do you feel?
Let's talk about dopamine. People call it the chemical of want and desire, but why is that? Well, here's how it works. From an evolutionary standpoint, your brain rewards you for anything that will increase your likelihood of survival by releasing a neurotransmitter called dopamine in your brain. That's the reason why it feels so damn good to have sex or to eat a steak, because our brain thinks that sex equals the reproduction of our species and that a fat piece of meat equals a long-lasting satiation. Let's look at an example. As soon as you're standing in front of your fridge and you have the choice to either pick a carrot or a piece of chocolate, your brain will tell you to pick the one which releases more dopamine, as it knows that it will make you feel more pleasure. So naturally, you will choose the chocolate. Now you might say, well, that's not too bad to eat a piece of chocolate every now and then. And that's true, but as soon as our brain releases a lot of dopamine, it will try to stimulate the craving for that thing over and over again until we develop an urge for it. And that's when the addiction kicks in and we can't live without it.
Did you forget you were watching a video and instead just felt lost in the story? You know it's a good video for YouTube when 60 seconds feels like 10. It's so common for viewers to drop off in the first 30 seconds of any video. For your videos to be good, you must fight this drop off. Nicholas combats this by making the first segment the most engaging of the entire video. He opens with on-screen text, and reading requires a viewer's active focus. Fast cuts also require viewer focus. I timed each of his cuts, and in his first 60 seconds, Nicholas cuts 28 times for an average 2.1 seconds in between each cut. And actually, that wasn't counting on-screen text cuts, so it's actually less than 2 seconds for each cut. That's nuts, right? But with a little more research, I realized this is actually very common among all the most viral creators across YouTube. A cut every 2 seconds in your opening is key for audience retention and fighting that initial drop-off at the start of your video. But fast edits and fancy graphics are just the surface. The real way humans have been hooked for thousands of years now is by storytelling. All good stories start with a hook or an engaging open. Nicholas obviously does this with his videos, but so do big Hollywood productions. The Dark Knight starts with the awesome bank robbery scene. Infinity War opens with the Asgardian ship in flames and deaths of two big characters. After the hook, it's time to establish a little context. Nicholas, after his first 60-second open explaining how dopamine works, proceeds to give us context about how corporations and powerful individuals manipulate our dopamine needs. Now we understand the setting of this video and where it's coming from. We have a good hook, some context for our video, and now we just need to set up the problem. Nicholas spends a minute explaining how the 7-day dopamine detox challenge is going to work. He explains his rules, what he thinks his challenges will be, and gives us an idea of what to expect the rest of the video. Because we've been properly engaged in these first 3 minutes, now we can get into the meat of the story, because now we care about this character named Nicholas and his challenge with too much dopamine. I found the most important element of storytelling is if your audience can relate themselves to the story and character. We immediately find Nicholas in a relatable situation, waking up and immediately going for the phone and social media. We see him struggle trying to figure out what to do instead. What a relatable situation. I mean, haven't you found yourself in that same spot where you wake up in the morning and you just immediately go for your phone? That relatable situation is what makes our character, Nicholas, so relatable. It's those little things that really increase watch time on YouTube. Eventually, we see Nicholas face all sorts of struggles in this video. And here's the key. We celebrate with him the satisfaction of when he conquers his problems. Nicholas finds real peace and clarity and joy when he overcomes his dopamine addiction. And I also feel it when I watch his video. That's the power of storytelling. A viewer comes with you on this journey from the setup, to the struggles, to the conquest, to becoming a changed, dynamic person. And Nicholas, whenever possible, shows us the story instead of telling it. Look at how many different angles and creative ways he takes us along his journey. This is something you can totally do yourself with just an iPhone and tripod. Honestly, the key is just effort. Put in the effort to show instead of telling your story. It does take practice and it feels awkward at first, but after 3 videos, you'll be just as good as Nicholas. To be honest, when YouTube first started suggesting Nicholas Crystal's videos to me, I never clicked on them. I expected him to be just another wannabe travel influencer bro. Until I watched him for the first time, and I've been hooked for this one reason ever since watching it, his first video. Authenticity. Nicholas never tries to be something he isn't. He isn't trying to be the coolest new Instagram influencer. When he talks to the camera, he speaks from his heart and he is honest and authentic. He laughs kind of nerdy, he makes mistakes, and he genuinely follows his passion, making YouTube videos. It's not like he was born, came out of the womb a good storyteller and editor. There's nothing special in him that isn't in you also. He just loves YouTube and is determined to learn. After a year, that paid off big time for Nicholas. So by trendjacking and finding what his audience wanted to watch, telling good stories, improving his editing skills, and being authentic, Nicholas gained 100,000 subscribers in 1 month. Growing on YouTube will take more effort than you think, but if you enjoy editing videos just like Nicholas and our community, I believe it's your duty to do so. Nicholas is living proof anyone can learn to create powerful videos. To map out your own pillars and keywords and start the same journey as Nicholas did, please sign up for PlannerVid below. We need creators like you to join our community because we need your videos to change the world. So please let me know in the comments below how you felt inspired by Nicholas's journey. It's just all the benefits of hard work, faith, and hope. Also, my last video hit 10 likes, so if we could get 20 likes on this video, that will help grow this community of strong YouTube creators.